Hi students, in this video we are going to discuss about the topic prodrug. Prodrug can be defined as it is a pharmacologically inactive compound that is converted into active compound by a chemical or enzymatic process. Initially prodrug is inactive in nature, so when it enters into the body it can be converted into active form. The prodrug to drug conversion can be occur before absorption, during absorption or after absorption at specific sites in the body. Prodrug can also be called as proagent, bioreversible derivative, latentated drug and congeners. In this picture you can see that the active form of the drug can be attaches with a cap. So here the cap can blocks the active functional groups of drug molecule. So we call it as prodrug. So when it enters into the body, so in vivo means in the body, so the prodrug can be converted into active form of the drug, and the cap which was used for blocking of the functional groups in the drug molecule can be separated and it should be easily eliminated from the body. So the designing of prodrug is essential in order to eliminate unwanted pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic drawbacks. So various pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamics includes unpleasant taste, odor, gastrointestinal effects, limited duration of action of the drug, instability, non-specificity of the drug molecules, poor absorption, poor distribution, etc. So these all parameters can be improved by the concept of prodrug. So prodrug is of three types. One is carrier linked prodrug, bioprecursor, site specific prodrug. Let me discuss about the carrier linked prodrug. The linkage of active drug to a carrier group which eventually undergoes enzymatic removal. So the linking of a carrier group to the active form of the drug, we can get a carrier linked prodrug. So these carrier linked prodrug, when it enters into the body, so the carrier can be easily separated by the enzymes which are present in the body with the help of hydrolysis process. The carrier group has certain properties such as non-toxic. The carrier group should be non-toxic, biologically it should be inactive, and it should be easily removable in order to efficiently release the active form of the drug. Examples for the carrier linked prodrugs are bacampicillin or pivampicillin. So bacampicillin or pivampicillin are examples for double esters. So double ester means two ester linkages are present in the structure. So these bacampicillin or pivampicillin are the derivatives of ampicillin. So ampicillin is a beta lactam antibiotic. So the beta lactam antibiotic ampicillin is poorly absorbed when it administered orally. Why? Because the ampicillin is having of polar functional groups such as a COOH group. So this polar functional group prevents the absorption into the systemic circulation. So that's why we have to administer 2.5 times more drug orally when compared with that of the same drug which is administering with the help of injection. So the extra doses of the drug may lead to more side effects, which includes resistance to the drug molecule, and as well as they can damage intestinal bacteria which are important for the digestion. A lipid soluble prodrug of ampicillin would be a useful approach to increase the absorption of the drug. So how to get a more soluble, more absorbable drug is we have to add certain lipophilic functional groups to the ampicillin. So the carrier what we are using for creation of prodrug is they should has lipid content, lipophilic nature. So by the addition of the lipophilic natured carrier to the ampicillin. Obviously, the absorption of the ampicillin can be improved. The various simple alkyl or aryl ester of thiazolidine carboxyl group of ampicillin are stable, therapeutically useful, but sterical hindrance can be occurred at a ester carboxylic group of the thiazolidine ring with the enzymes. Here the problem arises between the sterical between the drug molecule and the enzyme is when you use the carboxylic group when you use the carrier for the creation of ester linkage at COOH group of COOH group of drug molecule. Here the COOH group of drug molecule, so initially COOH will be present in the ampicillin. So if this COOH is used for the attaching of carrier to this functionality, we get an ester linkage. So if we use one ester linkage, if we create one ester linkage, sterical hindrance occurs between the drug molecule with the esterase enzyme. So that sterical hindrance can be prevented by that addition of two ester linkages at a carboxylic group of thiazolidine nucleus. Then we will block the sterical hindrance of the between the drug molecule and the esterase enzyme. So here the R and R dash positions are nothing but methyl and ethyl tertiary butyl groups. So they can, the bacampicillin or pivampicillin can varies at R and R dash positions. So first hydrolyze of the bacampicillin or pivampicillin, the first hydrolysis of the bacampicillin or pivampicillin releases hydroxylated methyl derivative. So first hydrolysis, the hydrolysis means addition of water. So by the using of water, the ester linkage can be broken, then we will get a hydroxylated methyl derivative. So spontaneously further hydrolysis can also be taken. The further in that further hydrolysis, another ester linkage of the drug molecule can also be broken. This is another linkage. The hydrolysis will be occurs at this site. So with the help of esterase enzyme, by using of water, then finally we will get the active form of the drug. The active form of the drug having free carboxylic acid functionality. This functionality is essential for the drug molecule to bind with a specific receptor. Targeted drug delivery. So non-specific distribution of the drug is responsible for side effects. So always non-specific distribution creates problem. Hence, targeted drug delivery is preferred since it decreases the side effects as well as the dose of the drug molecule which is to be administered. So by enhancing the selectivity towards the site of action, targeted drug delivery can be achieved by carrier moiety. So the carrier moiety is non-immunogenic, degrades immediately, pharmacologically inert, and the linkage which will be created between the drug molecule and carrier is stable in the blood stream, stable in the bloodstream and also in the extracellular space. The linkage must be broken at the site of the target by the enzymes. So these are various examples for carriers, that is antibodies, glycolipids, nanoparticles, peptide hormones, bioprecursor, prodrug. Bioprecursors are inert molecules obtained by chemical modification of the drugs but do not contain a carrier. In the creation of bioprecursor prodrug, we do not use a carrier. So we just modify the chemical modification. We just do the chemical modification upon the active form of the drug. Example, if the drug molecule contain carboxylic group, then the bioprecursor may be a primary amine. So when the prodrug enters into the body, so bioprecursor prodrug enters into the body, so that primary amine functional group undergoes for oxidation, and it can initial oxidation gives aldehyde functionality. Upon further oxidation, it gives a carboxylic acid. So like that, the original functional group can be regenerated in the structure when it enters into the body. Bioprecursor prodrug does not contain a carrier or pro moiety, but it contains a latent functionality that is metabolically or chemically transformed to active drug molecule. The type of activation includes oxidation, reduction, and phosphorylation or chemical activation. The first one is oxidative activation. So the example for the oxidative activation is nabumetone. So nabumetone is an NSAID. So NSAIDs are generally used for anti-inflammatory function. So they should have carboxylic acid functionality. That carboxylic acid functionality is essential for its activity. If a drug molecule is having COOH, then it can irritate the stomach. So we should not remove this carboxylic acid functionality. Why? Because it is essential for this drug activity. So we use this functional group for the modification. So this functional group, nabumetone, contains no acidic functionality. So the prodrug of nabumetone do not contain acidic functionality. In this picture, you can see that nabumetone prodrug, it has no COOH group in its structure. So this prodrug, when it enters into the body, so after absorption, the drug can be metabolized in the liver, and the active form of the drug can be generated. So this is the active form of the nabumetone, so which has COOH group. Next, reductive activation. Thiamine is a quaternary ammonium salt. It is poorly absorbed into the CNS from the GIT. So why? Because the quaternary ammonium means it is having polarity. So quaternary nitrogen valence is 3, but here the quaternary means 4 carbons are attached. So by that, nitrogen has a positive charge. So positive charge means a polar. So polar functionalities cannot be absorbed into the central nervous system. So to overcome this problem, we have to develop the lipophilic nature in the drug molecule. So to increase the lipophilicity of the thiamine, the tetrahydrofurfuryl disulfide is used as a prodrug. So tetrahydrofurfuryl disulfide can be attached, can be created upon the structure. So we will get a prodrug. So when it enters into the body, so that prodrug so permeates rapidly through the red blood cell membrane and reacts with the glutathione to produce thiamine. So that means this prodrug, so the prodrug which is having of tetrahydrofurfuryl disulfide, it can easily crosses the blood-brain barrier and reaches the central nervous system. There it can react with the GSH. Here the GSH is nothing but glutathione, so to produce thiamine. So like this we will get, in this pathway you can see that tetrahydrofurfuryl disulfide linkage which is added upon the structure of thiamine, so it can easily entered into the central nervous system. There it can react with the thiamine glutathione to produce the active form of the drug, that is thiamine. नेक्स्ट साइट स्पेसिफिक प्रोड्रग है। सेंट्रली एक्टिंग ड्रग्स मस्ट बी डिजाइंड इन सच ए वे दैट द ईजीली क्रॉसेस द ब्लड ब्रेन बैरियर। सो द ब्लड ब्रेन बैरियर विच कैन सेपरेट द सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम एंड फ्रॉम द एंटायर बॉडी। सो दिस इज मेड पॉसिबल बाई अटैचिंग अ लिपोफिलिक कैरियर टू द हाइड्रोफिलिक ड्रग मॉलिक्यूल इन ए क्लोजली बाउंड फॉर्म। सो टू इम्प्रूव द lipophilicity we have to add certain functionalities to the drug molecule which is in polar. So polar drugs do not process the biological membrane. Example, beta lactam antibiotic, a hydrophilic drug. So generally beta lactam antibiotic is having a polar functionality COOH, so it is hydrophilic drug and it is used in the treatment of bacterial meningitis, used in the treatment of bacterial meningitis. Because of its hydrophilicity and it cannot cross the blood brain barrier. So to overcome that problem, so prodrug dihydropyridine penicillin derivative, so dihydropyridine penicillin which can deliver beta lactam antibiotic in the central nervous system. Applications of prodrugs. First one is prodrug to improve patient acceptability. To overcome the bad taste of drug, following approach is used. That is, first the reduction of drug solubility in the saliva, and the other is to lower the affinity of the drug molecules towards the taste receptor. If the drug solubility cannot occur in the saliva, we could not feel any bad taste. At the same time, if the drug do not have affinity towards the taste receptor, at that time also we could not feel any taste. So that concept can be used in the creation of prodrug to improve patient acceptability. For example, chloramphenicol, it is a bitter taste containing drug. So it is not well accepted by the children. So chloramphenicol has bitter taste, so it is not well accepted by the children. So to improve the acceptance of the children, the palmitate ester of the chloramphenicol can be created. So that is having of less solubility in saliva, so it masks the bitter taste. Next application is prodrug to improve stability. So several drugs may decompose in GIT when used orally. Although enteric coating may be used, it is also possible to utilize prodrug design to overcome this problem. An anti-neoplastic drug, azacitidine, hydrolyzes readily in acidic pH, but the bisulfite prodrug of this one is more stable. So azacitidine can be converted into bisulfite prodrug. So after crossing of the acidic pH containing stomach, so that drug can be activated into azacitidine. Next, prodrug to overcome formulation problems. Formaldehyde is a flammable, colorless gas which could not be used directly as medicine. So a suitable solid hexamine, so methanamide is the drug, so is used. So in acidic pH, so hexamine, the pH of urine in the bladder is mildly acidic. 6.8 is the pH in the urine. So that mild acidic pH, so it helpful for the pharmacological activity of the drug hexamine. So the hexamine hydrolyzed to formaldehyde and ammonia in the acidic pH, mild acidic pH of the urine, so which acts as a urinary antiseptic. So that formaldehyde can act as a urinary antiseptic. So hexamine can be converted into formaldehyde ammonia in the mild acidic pH conditions. Next, the prodrug concept can also be used to improve absorption of the drug, site-specific delivery of the drug, slow and prolonged release of the drug, and improve membrane transport of the drug. Can also be used prolonged duration of the drug. This is about the prodrug concept.